Hello everyone, I'm Chris, and today we'll have a deep dive in the connectivity add-on in KUKA.Sim with OPC UA and Codesys. In the first part, we will write a little program for a photoelectric sensor that counts parts passing on a conveyor. Then you will learn how to connect it through the gateway to the simulation in KUKA.Sim. Let's get into Codesys.
If you open Codesys, you can directly go to your project or open a new one. So here we're going to use a new project and just create an empty project and call it test connectivity and then just create it. Once this is done, then we're going to add a Codesys instance here. For example, the Codesys for Windows Edition V3 is 64-bit. In our case, but this can vary to your project. Add this to our project, and from here on, we're going to configure a little bit our system. So first, we're going to add an application, and then we're going to add an object with a task configuration. Going to add a program organization unit here. We're just going to call it test program, and this will be our little program. So here we can now add our variables. We already prepared them, so I'm just going to copy and paste them here. We have the part at sensor variable, we have process part, we have a count of these parts, and a boolean which says if it starts or stops. Then the important thing here is the process time, so we have to add a little standard library element here, so it actually recognizes our process time. And then we add our little program. The idea is that as soon as a part comes by our sensor, we increment the counter, and once we have that, we have to actually also add a little symbol configuration or remote control. And added our task, we have to pull and drag and drop this test program to our task, then add the test program to our system. This is important because the remote connection then will include your variables that you select here. Great, and now we have actually to connect our Codesys through the gateway to our PC. In this case, it will ask us if we would like to connect it to the PC 24173 here, and ask us or if we have to search for it first, then we can find it with our Mac ID and then actually select it. And then if we run the code, we'll ask us that is a running system. We'll just hit yeah, and it will then be connected. And if we start the Codesys system, then we can actually jump back to our KUKA.Sim instance, where we actually already built up our little layout. So we have our conveyor, our creator, our sensor, and then on the connectivity add-on, we go to our server and we have to configure it. So we first have to test the connection. Here, if you click on that, it will work a little bit and then say, yeah, connection was established. And then you just have to hit on the lower side this takeover changes, and then actually activate or connect to the server. Then once you're connected, you can add the variables which you have then to connect. So we have our sensor boolean that we have to connect to the sensor in our Codesys program, which is our part at sensor variable. And then in addition to that, you will see on the lower part that the paired variables are written down there. We're going to do the same for the engine, so be connected to the variable path start, so the engine will stop and start as we wish it in our little program. Once this is done, we can now see it on the lower side with the connected variables, And as soon as then we start the program, and in this case we're just going to set the test connectivity project of our Codesys next to our little simulation. And I'm just going to create a little bit more view on the simulation. As soon as you do that and then start the simulation, you will see the parts, and you will see that the variables on the one hand will change in your connected variables, and on the other side you will see how it increments the part, and after our little wait time it will continue with the engine of the conveyor. And I hope that now you can actually connect your system on your Codesys program and PLC to KUKA.Sim and have fun with it. Thank you for watching this video. If you would like to see more interesting videos about KUKA's simulation world, feel free to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. Looking forward to seeing you in the next video.
Industrial intelligence.